Wysocki. Yeah. Big Dream's tee shot is short. Ricky Wysocki to tee second here. And like yesterday, Ricky Wysocki finds himself within 5 feet of the pin. James Conrad, third to tee. And James Conrad trickles left and OB getting the red flag. Fourth to tee, our 2008 world champion, David Feldberg. Germ taking a little extra time here on his first putt of the day, which was just straddling the 10-meter line. Conrad saves the par. Ricky Wysocki literally just 2 feet away. Dave Feldberg approximately 4 feet. Easy starts here on hole number one. We see three birdies and a par. Brief walk over to hole two. We'll be back in a moment. And here on this 616-foot hole number eight, Big Germ goes right up the middle. And Ricky comes just inside one of the trees on the right center side of the fairway. Great shot by Wysocki here off the tee. And Feldberg, third to throw, goes outside of the tree that Ricky was previously flirting with. Great shot here by Conrad. Four clean shots off the tee. Let's see what the women did earlier here on hole number eight. And Feldberg's approach is short and left. Approximately inside 150 feet, maybe 175 at most. And we saw the wind push it up and down. He comes up short. He's inside the circle looking at. And a gentle forehand with what I believe is a Firebird puts him just past the basket. And Conrad's attempt from 45 is short and left. And a push of wind, even though it's coming from left to right. And Wysocki has a headwind putt, does not get it up over the edge of the basket. And we're going to see some tap-ins for what will be par fours by all four competitors. Letting one slip by here. This is a great birdie opportunity for these long throwers. However, the wind affecting them here early on. Big Germ is in, and Feldberg will do the same. We'll be back with you in a few moments from the third hole right here at the Waco Annual Charity Open. Big Germ with a beautiful turn on that. Looks like it's finishing toward the right. The forehand turnover shot. And fighting through the right side is Wysocki's backhand drive. Curing the fairway here is James Conrad. Gets an applause, as he should, here on this. And also on the right side here, Dave Feldberg throws from the right side of the fairway to the left side, going with a patent pending stance, and finds just more shrubs on the left side. He's going to be hoping for a par here. Goes with an up and over. That may take someone's head off it when it comes down. And James hugging the left side of the fairway. He'll still be up there looking at a putt. What low line he's going to have to take here to get to the pin. Fighting through a little cabbage, but a kick back out. He'll have a putt from there.
Yeah, it looks like he's just in between the two circles, so he'll have a good look at a birdie three from there. It looks like he's inbounds. Often that sidewalk doesn't come into play because of how thick the woods are to get to the sidewalk, but it looks like he's safe.
Felber going up and over. And gets a forward roll. He's got to hope that stays out, and it does. He'll have a long putt from there to save his four. Big Germ corrects me and says 15. Wasn't sure he knew numbers that high. Okay. And a good skip up and a roll. That'll work.
Yeah, walking away with the par on this hole is totally fine. It's so easy to get off the fairway and take a five or a six on this hole. He did that very well.
Big Germ is in. Ricky Wysocki looking to put in from 10 feet, walk away with his par. So the first woods hole takes a little bite out of Dave Feldberg. We're going to move on. We have a short par 3 coming up next. You're watching the Waco Annual Charity Open right here with the Disc Golf Pro Tour.
Not getting quite enough turn on that, but he's still going to be on the hill for a putt. Looks like probably just outside the circle. And if that fades a little, he might have a look at the basket. And he's well within the circle. Very nice shot.
And Wysocki with a little bit of turn on the overstable mid. Skips up. We'll have a look from there. Fourth to tee will be Dave Feldberg. And Dave Feldberg pulls that right. However, it filters through into the circle too. He'll have a long look from there. Let's just off the top of the basket, a little uphill jump putt. And Conrad over the top of the basket. And Conrad converts. Ricky left with less than 15 feet. And Dave Feldberg will tap in. We'll be back in a moment after a word from our sponsors. Big Germ catches a tree on the left side. Wysocki's forehand is coming in nicely. It hits a tree, but does kick down and right toward the pin inside the circle. Smooth backhand here by Conrad, filtering down and toward the pin. And Feldberg also left side fairway.
And he pured it. That's going to be an easy three from there, but he's going to wish he had that two back.
And a simple approach by Feldberg puts him 5 feet away. And Rick had to maintain balance there. Certainly in, but he had to maintain his balance there. It looked like he was falling slightly left. Big Germ will save the three. James Conrad will tap in for the easy birdie. And Dave Feldberg will put in for the par. We'll be back with you guys in a few moments after a word from our sponsors. And welcome back, everyone. Hope you enjoyed our catch-up with Nico LaCastro. Again, quite the battling warrior here this weekend. Glad to see that he's okay, and clearly his golf game is on point. Cameron, we're watching Ricky Wysocki throw his tee shot, and that's about as good of a kick as you could ask for on this hole.
Yeah, really, if you can get out into the field at all, you're just fine. I like this hole a lot because it's one of the less difficult holes to eagle, and these guys can all reach it. But anywhere out in the middle, he's still going to have a look at a birdie. Even still a good kick out to the open field, he'll be fine.
A very unique hole in that you play through a tunnel out into this open area, and then there is a small ravine of sorts that players go over before getting to the basket finally, 460 feet later.
Yeah, you can really attack it with kind of what Germ just did, a turnover flick shot can get all the way there, or a hyzer flip with a backhand. Both of them are capable of getting down to that ravine and look at a putt. And Germ got near the road. He's going to have an interesting upshot from there.
Big Germ asking, well, really us, the camera crew down here, as to if he was in bounds or not. I gave him the safe indication. And Feldberg throwing a perfect shot. Feldberg has expressed a little bit of frustration here. There is a very large gallery, and we're kind of one of those double-edged swords. Hey, we've got galleries, we've got spectators. People are here watching, but we got to kind of fit through these tight corridors at the same time.
Yeah, this is pretty typical weather that you will start off in the morning with it cold and a little bit overcast. It rained a little bit, and now it's back to 70 and sunny, and it feels fantastic.
James Conrad going right up the gut. We talked about an eagle earlier. That's long. He'll have a death putt coming back at the basket, but that was a great line and right on point. And the powerful forehand coming through and gets caught up by a single hanging.
It holds pretty nicely, and he's up on the hill for a birdie putt. Very nice.
And Feldberg with an unforced error there, just really letting up too much and not putting the right angle on it. And Ricky's hits the top of the basket. It comes back and it rolls. However, it does sit down within 20 feet, but that was dangerous. That could have rolled right past him. And the definition of a death putt as James Conrad is looking straight downhill, but nothing but chains.
And Dave's in for birdie?
Very much so. Birdie for Dave Feldberg, again, showing a little bit of frustration out here today. A very active gallery, lots of people enjoying the action, but very tight corridors to be in. Big Germ is in for the birdie. Wysocki's got an uphill putt for par. And Wysocki is in. We'll be back in a few moments on the next hole. Stay tuned. You're watching live disc golf right here with the Disc Golf Pro Tour.
Yeah, it looked like he hugged that left side. It's not terrible in there. I think he's going to be okay, but he's going to wish he had this two back.
Big Germ asking for the backdoor route. Not sure that it got all the way through for him.
And Feldberg is going to find himself down the hill. It's kind of on the edge of 15's fairway. He'll still be able to get up and down from there, but there goes another two.
Ricky's trying to ring it up. He's coming straight at the pin, just passed. Here on this 213-footer. We'll be back in a moment after we see the women play hole 14. And a long lunging putt by James Conrad. He'll be short and left. And Feldberg gives it a run from approximately 45, close to 50 feet. He's going to move off here with a bogey four. That gives him 42, maybe 45 feet at most. He's looking at a death putt straight down the hill. I think he's going to lay this up. And Ricky Wysocki's in for birdie. Thanks for clarifying there. How'd your day go out here today?
It went a lot better than yesterday. I improved by 7 strokes, so way better.
We'll catch up with you more as we move into the next hole, which is a par 5 and a backup. See, you're out here enjoying the weather. Looks to be a gorgeous day. All right, we'll be back with you guys in a few moments after a word from our sponsors on the first par 5.
Practicing, he's going to try it again, so good on him. Very nice.
As I discussed with Madison, when you're playing a course that's this challenging, you really just have to wipe your memory clean from the day before, whether it was a good shot or a bad shot, and you need to come out and just execute again and keep it in the fairway. And Big Germ hits a tree center fairway that kicks to the right. He'll certainly be throwing probably a forehand from there to get back out. And Dave Feldberg on the tee.
A hyzer flip-up shot that's staying a little to the right, but comes out clean.
This is the first of two par fives that the competitors will see here today. I'm guessing that the flow will somewhat even itself out here. We talked about it a little bit earlier, seeing some of the lower scores get through the course earlier this morning. And now I think we should have a relatively good flow. We appreciate you guys tuning in, watching us here for the Disc Golf Pro Tour. And a harsh cut roller by Big Germ coming in. It hits off the tree branches and still carries forward quite the momentum.
Yeah, you have to be in just the right spot to find that ceiling, or lack of a ceiling.
And a long jump putt by Ricky Wysocki. I heard in the offseason Big Germ was taking forehand lessons from Madison Walker. And he likes it, gives himself the triple clap. That's one more than Feldberg typically gives. And he goes for the up and over with a putter. I was going to see if it holds that line. And he shrugs his shoulder and says, we'll see. He's hoping that shot works out for him.
Yeah, he has to stay away from that right side and get it to turn pretty quickly after that corner. It's a pretty difficult shot.
Perfectly placed shot by Dave Feldberg. That's going to put him in a great position for a really long eagle attempt, or at least the birdie four.
But he's lining up. That's inside the circle. Very nice.
And Big Germ giving it his all, getting a little bit caught up.
solid putt. Yeah, as Madison was saying earlier, this is one of the more treacherous greens on the course. We had a super difficult time even just painting the lines for it.
And a solid putt by James Conrad. And Dave is going to quietly sneak in with his birdie four. And the beast takes another bite. We've got a brief walk. We'll be back in a few moments after a word from our sponsors. Welcome back. We have Ricky Wysocki throwing his tee shot, which is low, and gets a really weird kick off of a stump here on the left side of the fairway.
Really, that was a fortunate kick. If he'd continued to go to that right or that left side, that's where the real trouble is. So he's going to be in the middle and still going to be up there for an easy birdie. I say easy. He's going to be able to go for a birdie.
James Conrad will be second to tee. And no surprise, Conrad straight down the center of the fairway. When I talked to him yesterday, he said he enjoys playing the woods golf that's featured here on the Beast. He says, I'm from Virginia, and I didn't really believe that they'd have woods golf. But when he got out to this back half of the Beast, he's like, all right, I feel right at home. And he's proving that as he's peering just about every fairway that he's approaching to.
Yeah, we're not all just pastures and cows here in Texas. We've got some woods here, too. And Feldberg is just on the edge of the fairway. He might be okay. You don't get a good run-up right there, but he can get a good standstill shot.
Feldberg with the furthest drive of the three thus far, however, off on the left side of the fairway. Big Germ opts for the forehand, and that's carrying right, and he's got some trees directly between him and the pin. Not so much the distance, but more so the angle from that spot. Frequently see both Big Germ and Ricky Wysocki with so many more options. And Wysocki following suit. He's going to take one knee for a forehand approach. Dave carries 67 discs in his bag. And the putting woes continue here on this green. Dave Feldberg is high and hits off the band. Wysocki is going to be placed just below the basket's edge, looking at 15 feet for comebacker. And Wysocki is in, and I think every competitor is ready to move off of this par four. Did a little more damage than they would have expected. We're going to move on to hole 17. We'll be back after. James Conrad going right up the middle with what I believe is a putter here on hole 17. Measuring in at 279 feet, slightly uphill.
Yeah, this is another hole that we didn't see many birdies on our feature card yesterday. There are a lot of trees to contend with, and that left side rough is pretty thick, and the right side stuff will just slow you down. Germ with a high one. If that hyzer's back a little bit, he'll have a... Ooh. Right by the basket. He's inside the circle.
And Ricky's looking for his forehand to turn over, however, it gets the tree. We've got more coverage from the women's round on hole 17. We'll be back in a moment. Feldberg's going to need that to sit down.
Dead center.
You called it.
Because I don't brush my hair in the morning.
Feldberg's in, and we're also catching wind of a backup. Very tight fairways here for both players and media and gallery. James throwing a putter off the tee there, Paige?
Yep, putter turnover. It's refreshing to see on this card of sidearm dominance. So
he caught a tree on what was his left side. However, it did land perfectly in the fairway. It didn't go more than 150 feet here off the tee. Not the start he was looking for, but at least it's in the fairway.
Fairway is key. If you're 300 feet or 150 feet, as long as you're in the middle, that's where you want to be. Awesome shot by Germ. Sidearm with an 8-6 in Firebird. He's right in the fairway.
Yesterday we saw Ricky Wysocki take a backhand here. I'm still unsure what he was attempting, but here he goes with the forehand as you'd expect.
Great kick right into the center of the fairway, even farther than Germ's was.
And Ricky couldn't see where that finished. I think he'll be actually very pleased. We know if Ricky does an ace, he's somewhat disgusted with himself, but that was a really good shot for Ricky. And Feldberg with a mid-range turnover, left side. He's going to have some work to do.
Yeah, a little pinched up on the left side. He's going to have to do some sort of scrambling. And I believe also Lisa, they're all three tied for third. But Lisa was on our card and had the worst round of the three, so Melody will jump up for the lead card.
And another turnover shot. Looks like it might have caught edge. Cut forehand roller by Big Germ. That's going to work out nicely. Backhand turnover by Wysocki, hoping that comes in flat. And it carries left. He'll have a little bit of work to do. Long putt from there. And James Conrad has hit a tree directly in front of him. It was no more than an arm's length away. Immediately upon release, it had kicked off the tree, and that stroke is going to punish him in what looks like multiple ways. Not only did he only carry about 5 to 8 feet in front of him, but I think his line is going to be just as obstructed.
Yeah, I think he actually hit that during his swing. I don't think he left his hand before it hit the tree, and he's giving up a couple of strokes right there.
Very painful to see here. James Conrad on this left side rough. He's going to attempt another forehand that's coming out. It's panning and still back in the left on the left-hand side.
Absolutely. The way that this course challenges you, it really evens the field between all the pros because you have to have such a variety of shots. I personally think that this course favors long throwers and long forehands, and we have quite a few guys at the top that have that Germ and Wysocki, but it's really difficult out here. One bad kick can change around for you.
Very long jump putt by Big Germ. 70 footer uphill. I believe it will move us into our final third of the course here today. Listen to a word from our sponsor as well as a whole preview for hole number one. Thank you guys for tuning in and watching the second round of the Waco Annual Charity Open. Waco Annual Dynamic Disc. We'll also give you the women's footage from the holes moving forward. We'll be back in a moment. Power forehand by Big Germ with a right, left to right wind pushing, and gives himself the single clap. Very well executed. We'll see if Ricky goes with the backhand roller we saw from him yesterday.
Yeah, it looks like he's got his vision in his hand. I think that's what he's going to do. Again, hopefully the wind is pushing towards right. Hopefully he can get it out to the left a bit before it happens. He can keep it in bounds.
A different disc here. And after a few different disc swaps, Ricky ultimately has it carrying toward the OB. That is not going to stand up. And it has gone OB over the sidewalk and carries into the second hole's fairway. And Feldberg with the straight air shot that's going to have a gentle fade left. It hits a tree, however, still in the center of the fairway.
James trying to attack the right side of the fairway here. He gets a nice S-curve way up the fairway. I think that looked like another T-bird.
Oh, and flashing just in front of the basket. Great effort by Dave Feldberg.
And a nice forehand shot up. And settle under the basket. He's going to be able to take a circle four on this hole. Honestly, this hole always feels like a tweener. It's either a very difficult par three or a pretty easy par four. It's kind of in the middle.
Big Germ going with a Nova out around the same tree we saw Feldberg pass by on the right side. James Conrad with the longest drive in the group, approximately 35 feet outside of circle two. Looks like just about 100 feet. And when you throw a drive that far, this definitely makes the birdie three relatively easy. Feldberg will tap in. We're going to have a very brief walk over to the tee on the next hole, what is normally course hole number two. Also our Zucca Mando. Wysocki cleans up for the par four. High and in for James Conrad, and Big Germ taps in. We're going to move on to hole two in just a moment. Stay tuned. You're watching live disc golf right here for the Disc Golf Pro Tour. germ with a simple forehand out to the left side as it carries right with a slight tailwind. And James not quite wide enough. And Wysocki with a left side forehand coming in nicely with a hard skip to the right. Ricky, a little bit of struggle here on holes one and two.
Solid putt. That's a 1-2. We're going to get 2-2s out of this hole, and this is another short under 300-foot hole that still has some teeth on it.
Both Feldberg and Ricky Wysocki gesturing and talking to themselves, both very frustrated with their effort. And James Conrad will tap in. Big germ with the lone birdie here on hole number two. I would have never predicted that. Find it live on udisclive.com and right here on the Disc Golf Pro Tour. We'll be back in a moment. Big germ going with an overhand here off the tee, trying to eliminate all of the OB that's found on the both the right and left side of the fairway at this 558-foot hole number three.
Yeah, that line was new to me. I've not seen that before, but not many people also have that range on the thumbers.
Playing a turnover, hoping that pans out. It's doing so, and inbounds for James Conrad. And Wysocki also going right up the middle with a very solid shot.
And Feldberg puts his inside the circle nicely. He's going to be about 15 feet away. Skipped a little bit behind it, but it looks like he might have about a 20-foot putt from there. This hole plays more than 560 feet. And it looks like all of these guys are in the circle, going to be putting at a birdie three. And he puts it in, putting upside down. He says that helps the wind not get trapped underneath the disc.
Okay.
germ cleans up is 4.
And great concentration by James Conrad. Some spectators were moving in the background, and Rick is in as well. We have a backup on the next hole, so we're going to bring you a few words from our sponsors, as well as catching up with Jonathan Cook from the Waco Events Planning Committee. Talked with him earlier and the support that Waco gives to disc golf. We'll be back in a moment. And Feldberg putting down a massive roller earlier today, and watching Nicola Castro, he put it to within 12 feet of the pin. This looks like it's finishing right, but I can't see that far. I'm not as tall as you, Big Germ.
How far do you think he is, Terry, in feet?
In fact, it sounds as if it's rolled out of bounds.
Okay. Well, just keep your opinions to yourself, Terry.
And it looks like we're getting one air shot out of this cart. I would expect everybody to throw a roller with the way the wind is right now. Ooh. Did you hit the T sign? Is that what just happened? Ouch.
Ooh, hopefully that catches edge and starts traveling right, but he put it way left enough to where OB is not in question.
He's trying to sit down.
He actually overthrew the hole. He's going to have like about a 30-foot putt looking back at it.
Big Germ with a roller. What's he throwing there, Paige?
I saw it, and it looked like a Champion Roadrunner. His other option was a Pro Boss, so I would say that was a good option as it's curling up nice, similar to Rick's.
And again, players scattered everywhere throughout trying to track them down and see who's out and who will be throwing first. Looks like James Conrad will be first to approach.
Some really strong tailwinds pushed that disc down a little bit early.
Feldberg will have a chance to get up and down here to save the par 4.
Hey, gave it a good little soft run.
Yeah, still looking at a birdie. Rarely do you have a long birdie putt from penalty area, OB.
None of these guys can keep their putters in the air.
And Ricky opts for the spin putt, and he puts it just a few feet from the basket. James Conrad again, approximately 15 feet, but he's going to have to throw this hard and put it up over the center of the chains. Trying to keep it high so that knowing the tailwind would push it down, maybe overcompensated slightly.
I think perhaps maybe traffic was a little bit of a distraction. It's 5 o'clock right here in Waco and everybody's on the way home Friday night.
Wind picks up. Moving on, just two holes left to play here today during the second round of the Waco Annual Charity Open on the Disc Golf Pro 2. Putting is hard, I think a good friend of mine once said. Scott Burtard, what do you think of that?
I think we're throwing tee shots already. I feel like I just saw a disc roll over there. Yeah, no, that was definitely too much tailwind. He did not get it high enough for it.
All right, we're going to step aside from the putting and move over to the drives from our lead card. They are anxious and ready to go. That looks like a solid forehand shot, perfectly positioned.
Yeah, absolutely. He put it right where the old position is, and from there you can actually see the basket, which, you know, anything short of that you cannot, and you're dealing with some blind shots with water and OB on either side.
Dave Feldberg was telling us on the walk over that yesterday he threw his shot on 17 the other direction. He had no idea that the previous hole had the OB sidewalk. And so unless they put in that sidewalk overnight, I think Dave's going to have to account for that. He threw a roller here. He's in the fairway and safe.
Yeah, from there, though, he's still not going to be able to see the basket. He's going to be thrown blind, and I guess he's going to have a big turnover. But with the wind blowing the way it is, he's going to throw it very carefully.
James Conrad going out and around. That's coming directly at us, and we're going to move as Conrad goes deep, but not OB. He comes up just 3 feet short of the OB paved landing area here for boats. Looks like he's a few feet behind it. Shouldn't be a problem. However, visually, that's got to be distracting.
Well, I think he's going to have to try and force this to the right, which is, I think, may come into play for his backswing on that. We'll see. It's going to be a difficult shot for him. He's turned it a bit much, but hopefully he gets down and stays in. I think I heard it hit the wall. The green flag is up. Fantastic. Yeah, from there, there's actually another shot where he could throw over the rough, a little S-curve, but with the wind, it's a pretty difficult one, so I would expect going wide over the water, but we'll see what he... A roller? I wonder if that was intentional.
And Wysocki's forehand is carrying out and over and toward the pin, and hits nicely and sticks the landing. And big germ, maybe a little bit tentative to go out over the water, but it looks like he should have carried that wider.
Just off the chains, a very close three on that. He's going to settle for four, but...
And Big Germ does not grab metal.
What a heartbreaker, and so we don't get any birdies on this hole. A few close ones, but this again just shows the teeth you can have even on more open holes to the beast.
And they'll finish off. We got a long walk up to the final hole of the day. Stay tuned right here with the Disc Golf Pro Tour in Waco, Texas.
It's fun to watch guys throw across, but with this wind as stiff and as brutal as it is right now, I think everybody's going to be going for the hyzer layup on the left side.
And Ricky has done just that, going for the hyzer layup, which is carrying left, and that's in a great position.
Looks like he's considering going across.
And And he's doing just that. He's going for it. That's turning over, and that's going to finish out nicely. That's tracking toward the pin. We'll see if it's got too much. And I believe that is safe back behind the pin.
There is a line that extends back from those signs right there, and it's kind of hard to tell from here. He went pretty long, but he's definitely within 60 feet on that.
And Feldberg's looking for that to stable up. That looks to be a great shot, also tracking toward. It's going to be short, but it is safe, and the crowd loves it. Conrad taking the Ricky approach out and to the left. That should finish in the fairway, and we'll see.
Perfect.
And Ricky Wysocki looking to complete the round as quickly as possible. Not quite the eagle throw in, but definitely a birdie to finish off. We're going to see Ricky Wysocki, of course, tomorrow here on the leader card. If James Conrad can come in with a birdie here on the final hole, he will also maintain leader card position. No correction. This just in, Greg Barsby is officially in. And Feldberg puts himself within 10 feet of the pin. His leader card chances slip by as he finished with a birdie instead of the eagle that he was lined up for. Jeremy Koling sitting at 21 under par. In and out, a heartbreaker. He's going to have to settle for birdie. He'll move to 22 under and maintain the lead going into the final round. James Conrad with a solid performance today, finishing at 8 under par. That moves him to 19 under. He's going to be sitting in a tie for 5th place. Wysocki will tap in, as will Big Germ. And there you have it. That is our second round. We are complete.